As I lay me down to sleep, I hear her speak to me. Hello, Mari, how you doing? I think the storm ran out of rain, the clouds are moving. I know you're happy, 'cause I can see it. So tell the boys inside your head to believe it. I talked to God about you, he said he sent you an angel. And look at all that he gave you, yes, for one and you got two. You know I never left you, 'cause every road that leads to heaven's right beside you. So I can say, hello, my only one. Just like the morning sun, you keep on rising till the sky knows your name. Hello, my only one. Remember who you are. No, you're not perfect, but you're not your mistakes. Hey, 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 hey. Oh, the good outweighs the bad even.
Alright, guys, welcome back to the channel. This will be our second month apartment update. Me and Roran are super excited to show you some of the stuff we got in our second month. This video, we're gonna just be talking a little bit, but if you guys continue watching, we'll show you guys a bunch of random clips of our second month of being here. But we'll start off with one of our favorite items, which is the couch.
Last video, it took us a while to kind of film this. We did plan on it, but we kind of, a lot of stuff happened this month. Was it this month? We got it, what, last month?
Yeah, this month? Second month of being here was a tough month for us personally. In our personal lives, my grandmother passed away. We had to deal with that. My mom was living with us for a little bit. It was just like a really tough time for our second month here, so we didn't really like record stuff. It's just kind of like we were just living here. We weren't picking anything up. We weren't like decorating, nothing. We were just living.
You know, it's still taking us a while to kind of purchase certain things for the apartment. I know it typically does take a long time to furnish your apartment, and we're in no rush.
Yeah.
Especially plus, you know, we have bills on top, we're always working, so we don't always have the time, but we are still working on it.
Yeah, so when you guys move out to somewhere, some people like want to rush. At first, we wanted to rush and buy all our furniture and also decorate everything completely. But one, just take your time, and then two is that also budget your money so that you're not getting burnt out just like buying stuff for your place where you don't have any like income to like spend on other stuff.
It is called an alocasia.
Got some plates.
More rags.
Oh, Cardi, I need a friend.
You know, I'm into streetwear and stuff like that, so I have to like really manage my money when it comes to bills and like purchasing a bunch of different things. So taking our time was like a really main focus, but we did get our cash that we did bought before we even moved out. This is actually going to be a cash from Living Spaces. This is called the Aquarius 2. It is a sectional. Me and Roanne did a lot of couch shopping, if you didn't see from the first video. Yeah.
Stuck on it, and we didn't want a chance on any other couch. We almost wanted to look for like a
We try to find like alternatives, but price-wise and comfortability and sizing, like there's so many factors. There's like, there's things that we did like, but it was like either overpriced or like maybe like the arm rest is like shaped differently, or like it was just a bunch of random stuff. But this was the couch that fit our budget that we wanted to spend, the colorway that fits our aesthetic for our apartment, and also just the sizing of it, because this is a one-bedroom apartment. So like there was other couches that were nice, but they were way too big for our apartment, and we don't want to be like couch to couch, the wall to wall.
You can't even like move it. Okay, yeah.
Yeah, especially for just two people. Like, we do have guests and stuff like that, but we're not about to have like 50 people in our small apartment. So big couches and like what we needed at this moment. But yeah, this is like the main thing that we got. The other thing that we finally got was our drawers for our bedroom. That was gonna be, it was the mom from IKEA. It's the white one, 6 drawers. We'll show you guys the clip of us trying to build it. It took us a while. We don't have any, like, we have like basic tools, but like you don't really need all the crazy tools, but
it was just doing it like at a beginner. We have like a beginner's tool box, not even a kit. We have a screwdriver,
a hammer,
and like
just basic stuff. Like it was just like I don't know about you guys. I personally didn't like, I feel accomplished when I build something, but the whole the directions that are given, if it's not like super clear and I have to like really think and like figure stuff out, I hate the experience, in my opinion. But I don't know, she liked building and stuff.
I think part of living together, building all our like first purchases, like big purchases, like furniture and all that, I thought at first we panicked when we opened the directions up for the drawers, but after we actually sat down and really looked at it, I think the times that we did some steps wrong, but that wasn't even our fault. That was because IKEA's directions weren't as up to par.
Like you really gotta like pay attention to what bolts or whatever like is what, and like which way something is, like it has to be like perfect, because if you're trying to follow the directions, not perfect, you're gonna be putting things backwards and then you have to fix it.
It took us a couple times to get it right, but
yeah, I was getting frustrated,
but I think I laughed a lot about it after more than single. Yeah.
And the funny story with that one is that it took us so long to get the actual drawers because they were always sold out. We were like visiting IKEA like every other week, and then we finally got it. And
the time that they did restock, I kind of just like randomly, it was during like, yeah, it was during a rough week, and I randomly checked IKEA and we saw it and we rushed over there and we got it. We didn't even expect it to be there. Same on thought it was just gonna be a mistake going in, but then we did get it and we didn't even think about how we were gonna fit into our car.
Yeah, the drawers were like hanging out on my trunk.
Our trunk was open, and we just, good thing we live literally right by IKEA, so it wasn't that bad. We
finally ordered our TV stand, so that's another thing to build. That'll be for our third month update probably. We're gonna try to get other things. I know Ryan's been buying like certain things like for the kitchen and like a little decoration. Like fall is coming, so we might like decorate stuff for like maybe winter, maybe fall. We haven't decided.
I'm trying to, at first we were going for a more modern, minimal look, but now that the it's almost fall season, I don't want to go too crazy, but I've been looking at like Pinterest and
yeah, she wants to decorate and stuff. That's more of her like realm and stuff like that. Me, you know me. Yeah, like my streetwear and stuff like that. So I don't really like.
We actually still need to get couches for the, or pillows for the couches
We need pillows, we need a throw blanket, like we need a coffee table, we need a rug.
We don't need too much, honestly. For furniture wise, we only need like a couple more pieces. We're not trying to get too many things, right? Just in case, you know, we move out and or if we don't even stick around too long, that and we just don't want to feel crowded.
Yeah. Yeah, but everything that we're buying, it's like literally we could take this stuff and move it into a house and like keep it instead of like get rid of it. Something that I should share with you guys is like it, like I understand being budget friendly is important to some people, but like don't be settling for stuff that you don't want or you want to get rid of later on. There's no point in spending that money for like however long you're staying at a place and then getting rid of it. Like this couch is fire regardless. Like. Some people might not get this because they have pets or kids and stuff like that.
And
we don't. We try not to eat on the couch. Like we try not to bring drinks or anything like that. Like so, it's just so we can take care of it, not being stained and like stuff like that. But like literally invest into what you actually like. Don't settle for less and always shop around and look around. Like we for the couch, I felt like we needed to be in person, actually feel it and like touch it and see it in person. Other things is like we try to like look in stores and stuff like that, but if you have to online shop because sometimes you can get a better deal or a better design. And it's okay, like you just look at photos, look at reviews, see if they it fits what you're going for. I know some people have a hard time, Ryan has a hard time like looking online and like trying to look at pictures is not the same as in person. Just take your time when you guys are buying furniture for your place. Really look out there. Sometimes you can find something for a good price or you can find like something that has a great design that you're not gonna see at IKEA or something like that. But
and I think our place is just slowly coming together. I don't want to really rush buying like a bunch of stuff thinking I really want it. Like it takes, I don't know, sometimes I think I want it and then I think about it again and
she's like, nah.
Yeah, change my mind. So I don't mind that we've been kind of like in and out on purchasing things. We're very indecisive.
Me, I'm just kind of like, she just asked me, I'm like, she just asks me, I'm like, yes or no, or I'm like, or I say it's up to you, because I'm not really like,
whatever I want.
Yeah, I'm like more modern, like, I want to do like hype stuff, and like, I want to like, try to like, put my own take on it, like, I want a bear brick, I want a freaking bear brick, like, that's like, no function, like, functionality in that whatsoever. I want a bear brick just to display, and that's like gonna cost more, probably more than the couch, which is like crazy. I like stuff like that like adds a touch to like stuff we like. Like we got something from like the Menace collection that I did, that rug. Like Brian liked that rug too, and it would just add like a nice like flavor to our apartment. But we're gonna take you guys into the bedroom and show you guys like the drawers that we built. But before that, we'll show you guys the clips of us building it, but we just want to show you guys like us like showing it to you because we didn't really show you guys the final product of it being built. So we're gonna go take you guys into the bedroom. The bedroom is like the last place we really like
want to show it.
Yeah,
our bedroom honestly mainly holds all of our stuff. It has the most boxes right now. We still need to get a bed for you. My mattress is still sitting around, but after we get our TV stand, we'll probably work on the bed. But it's not our big focus. Our closet's a mess. But just the part where you can see our drawers, that's the only nice part.
Okay, so we'll see you guys in the next. Thank you.